If tonight you stood in heaven's court to seek eternal favor, would you face Jesus Christ as judge, or would you face him as your savior? There are many who don't quite know for sure what that verdict would be, if ever. So let's imagine for a moment you're standing dead center in the courtroom of forever. Sitting before you is a structure, massive and intense. It's here your fate will be determined, before this judge's bench. Then a voice booms, this court's now in session, and your adrenaline starts to rush. Peering down with eyes that see through your soul is God the Father, your judge. Then off to your left across the room is the virtual silhouette of sin. Stepping out of the shadows of condemnation, your worst nightmare walks in. On his face is the smirk of evil incarnate, his mind fixed on your destruction in hell. You've just been introduced to your prosecuting attorney, none other than Satan himself. The Bible says he's the accuser of the brethren, so guess what he's gonna do. He's gonna accuse you of your sins, and he knows them all, both the old ones and the new. He's prepared his case for years. Now the golden moment is his. So in arrogance, he presents his case to the judge, and it comes out sounding something like this. You see this worthless piece of trash over here? This one's a sinner to the core. This one's committed adultery, cursed his neighbor, stolen money, been into drugs, alcohol, and even more. This hopeless wretch has even slandered friends. And by that guilty face, this whole courtroom can tell that to a moral certainty and beyond any reasonable doubt, this one deserves eternal judgment in hell. Accusations still echo, your every sin thrown up in your face. Then God opens the book where every deed is recorded and reviews your records of disgrace. God says, the book says you did this, this, and this, and everything you were accused of today. Now before I sentence you to hell forever, are there any last words you have to say? Now if it's true you're standing there in the courtroom of eternity, with God to your front and Satan, the prosecutor, to your left, there's one remaining eternal truth, one that's crucial to remember, one you should never, ever, ever forget. That on the other side of the courtroom, I said, on the other side of the courtroom, you ain't hearing me tonight. I said on the other side of the courtroom, the one and only Son of God, revealed in time and space. And he's your defense attorney, who has never lost a case. It's not Buddha, Muhammad, or Krishna, or any others who succumb to death. Ladies and gentlemen, on the other side of the courtroom is Jesus Christ of Nazareth! Then Jesus jumps up and says, wait a minute, Judge, now I've got something to say. May I remind you that on the cross 2,000 years ago, I washed his sins away. I was crucified, I died, they put me in a tomb. But long about the midnight hour, the power of God hit me and I walked out of that grave, alive and well with resurrection power. Out, lays it open and says, now we'll see what this book has to say. He turns to the first page, a second page, a third. By the fourth, the devil seems shook. God closes it, says, the blood of Jesus must have worked, because there's absolutely nothing in this book. The devil says, now wait a minute, check that book again. All the sins are written down, they're all right there. God said, devil, maybe you're mistaken altogether. Maybe it's this other book down here. The devil cries, no, not that book, not that one. God said, devil, why are you so uptight? God sets the book down, the dust flies, and on the cover it says, the Lamb's Book of Life.
I said, friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. My life when I need it to live. He's everything to me in this life that life can give. He's my living water when I needed that drink. He's the first thought in my mind each time I try to think. His friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. Joy, oh, that I love to feel. He's everything in this life to me that's really real. He is love, the only real love I've known. He can wash you in his precious blood, make you white as snow. I said, friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. You can't take God's love away from me. I hear me talking to your friend, you can't take him, he's all I got. He's everything in this life I'm ever gonna need. Is everything in this life I'm ever gonna need.
Amen and amen. He's everything in this life I'm going to need. Amen. This is Evangelist Chris Chaney with Saving America One Soul at a Time, coming to you out of the on the Gospel Music Jukebox. Amen. From the Soul Filling Station Worship Center. Amen. But today on this program, just wanted to talk about calling the devil out. Amen. Calling out the ways of the world, letting the devil know that we know the children of God, that we know who he is and we know what he's doing, and we're sick and tired of sitting back and watching it happen. Amen. We're going to get up and do something about it. Amen. We're going to be a doer of the word. Amen. We calling you out, devil. Amen. And we know what comes with that. We know we got to be put on the full armor of God. We know that we got to be dressed. We know that we're in a spiritual war. Amen. And no longer is it time to sit on the sidelines. Amen. It's time to get in the middle of this spiritual war. It's time to get down and dirty. Amen. It's time to stand up and proclaim the name of Jesus Christ, the power of God. Amen. And take it into this lost and dying world and fight this spiritual battle with God leading us. Amen. Because if God be for us, then who can be against us, my friend? Amen. But it's time that we call the devil out. Amen. Amen. Give us testimony. Listen, be blessed.
Hello, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We love you all. We're praying for you. I was calling in to read something called Faith, Doubt, and Unbelief that I wrote. Do we truly believe that all things are possible with God, Luke 18:27? And, you know, we need to have faith. God rewards our faith. I said here, how is our faith doing? Do we truly walk by faith and not by sight? Do fear, doubt, unbelief destroy our faith when we're tested with trials, hardships, and challenges in our lives? In Hebrews 11:6, we're told that we must have faith to please God. 2 Corinthians 5:7 tells us to walk by faith, not by sight. Do we walk by faith or do we doubt? Hello, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We love you all. We're praying for you, and God bless you. I was going to read a couple things here. I was on Bishop Eddie Cheney's Facebook page, and it looks like they're giving out free CDs, and he's been making CDs. I've been making a lot of calls in for the CDs, praying for people. We've been praying for the elderly in the nursing homes and for doing all kinds of different prayers and testimonies as well as preachings on here. And it says, God bless my friends and family. If you'd like to have a free CD that we give away here at the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio Program, just simply message me your emailing address and we'll get one out to you in the mail, my friend, absolutely free. My email is the.gospel.music.jukebox@gmail.com. Program today is one of those for free CDs that we give away. Remember, a CD may have a different testimonies according as we receive them. And God bless. Now enjoy. So if you'd like to have a CD, you can email Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney and we'll get one to you. And this is our testimony thing. I'd like to encourage you to call in and share testimonies for the CDs. Lift up the name of Jesus and thank him for all that he's done. Please call 1-931-329-0768. Share your pre-recorded testimony. This is your day of victory. Someone needs to hear they're worth your time. Someone needs to hear God's grace is for them. Someone needs to hear that their darkest sins are not too dark for God's light. Someone needs to hear there's hope. Someone needs to hear peace can come. Someone needs to hear about a second chance through Jesus. About us stepping out and doing our part. Who's going to tell them? Lift up the name of Jesus and thank him for all that he's done. Please call 931-229-0768 and share your pre-recorded testimony. This is your day of victory. We here at the Gospel Music Jukebox are well aware that everyone cannot call from different countries. We still offer you a way to share your testimony. Just simply email your testimony to us here at the.gospel.music.jukebox@gmail.com. We will read aloud and share your testimony or Bible question or comments over the radio program. Will you help us? I'd like you to encourage you to call in and share your testimony. They overcame by the word of their testimony. It says in the book of Revelation, Ephesians chapter 3, 12 through 13, tells us to encourage our brothers and sisters daily so that no one develops a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. And we can help our brothers and sisters. We can pray for each other. We can share testimonies. We can preach on there. Please call 931-229-0768 and share your testimonies that can be used on the live programs or that can also be used to make the CDs with to help people out. I called in many calls myself today. I even called in a good testimony earlier as well as prayers and preaching. So God bless you all and have a good day, and please share your testimony. Amen.
Amen and amen, Brother Boyd. You know, I stand amazed. I stand amazed every time God does something. You know what I'm saying? It blows my mind every time. Even though I know He's capable, and I know what He's told me and what He's shown me. And I know God, amen. But I stand amazed, amen. I stand amazed. But you know, we are living in the end time. We truly are in the end time. And it's truly time that we stand up as the children of God, amen. And we no longer let sin go by us without saying anything or doing anything. Amen. We got to call shit out. Amen. We in the last time. We ain't got time to play with it. We ain't got time to mope around. Amen. We better grow up and grow up fast in Jesus Christ. Amen. It's time to be the soldiers of God. Amen. It's time to call the devil out. Amen. It's time to call him out. Amen. But I tell you, I really do stand amazed. Amen. At Jesus Christ and at my Heavenly Father. Amen. I truly do.
I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and I wonder how He can love me, a sinner condemned and clean. How marvelous, how wonderful, shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. He took my sins and my sorrows and them is very old. He bore the burden to Calvary and suffered and died alone. How marvelous, how wonderful in my song shall shall see. It will be my joy through the ages to sing of His love for me. How wonderful is my Savior.
Amen and amen. I truly stand amazed that Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, amen, the all-powerful, amen. I'm telling you, God is all-powerful, all-knowing. You can't hide nothing from him. You can't push it under with a broom. You can't put it in a closet, amen. God sees all, knows all. So you're going to stand before God one day, amen. But I'm telling you, the devil is running rampage in the churches and people's lives, and I'm sick and tired of it myself, amen. God has called me, chose me, and put me on the front line, amen, to preach this gospel, to go and take the word, the true living word of God, to the lost and dying world, amen. And I'm not afraid of the devil from the pit of hell, amen, because I got God on my side. And it's time that we call the devil out, amen, for what he really is, amen. No more sitting on the sideline. No more sitting back just pretending to be something that you ain't. My God, it's time to call it out. It's time to rise above it. It's time to put the devil under her feet where he belongs, amen. And it's time. It's time because we're living in the end time. It's time because God says it's time. It's time because God is purposing people's hearts. It's time because God is bringing up a people that is full, plumb full of the Holy Ghost with the bold Spirit of God and is going to preach the Word of God. Amen. And ain't going to worry about what people say. Ain't going to worry about what people think. We know who we fight against. We know who the enemy is, and the enemy is the devil himself, amen, spiritual wickedness, amen, in high places. That's who we fight against, amen, and it's time to call it out, amen. It's time to let people know. It's time for people's eyes to get opened, amen. It's time. It's time to suit up, because God has got an army, amen.
Into the land. Let me hear.
Amen and amen and amen and amen. God's got an army. Amen. Amen and amen. And Brother Willie says, hey, brother, who sings that? That's Carmen, brother. Carmen. Amen. But God's got an army. Amen. But it is time. We are in the end days. It's time that we call the devil out. Now, that comes with a price, my God. You better make sure you got yourself ready for this end time battle. Amen. You better make sure you got the full armor of God on. You better make sure you get sin out of your life. You better make sure that when you go, you better count that cost. Amen. Because I'm telling you, you might not come back. Amen. But it don't matter. You know why? Because God's got her hand. Amen. But you better suit up, armor up, baby. Take that word of God, the sword, baby, and you put on take the shield of faith with you, amen, the helmet. My God, we got to get suited up. We got to put on the full armor of God, because there's a spiritual battle going on, and God's raising up an army, amen. He's raising up an army that ain't going to back down, that ain't going to go sideways, that's going to hold on to the hand of God, and is going to march straight through the pit of hell, amen, and is going to bring out as many as we can with us. Through the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Through the name of Jesus Christ. I tell you, God called me, purposed me, changed my whole life for this. Amen. And I'm going to battle with or without anybody. I'm stepping on the front line. Amen. I'm going out where God's going to send me. I'm going to say what he tells me to say. Whether you like it, don't like it. Flip upside down, put it in a can, put it in a pipe and smoke it. Amen. Because time's out. It's running up. It's already too late. Amen. Too many excuses. Too many people whining and crying. My God, we ain't got time. What we better be doing is getting on that front line. What we better be doing is getting suited up. What we better be doing is calling the devil out. Amen. Calling the devil out. And we need to let the devil know these false religions, all these false things getting taught in the churches, all these people telling the people, leading them straight to hell, call them out, amen. Call them out in the power and the authority of Jesus Christ, amen. We're going to call the devil out, amen. And we tell the old devil, we say, Satan, bite the dust. Amen.
Over. Shut it down. I'm hunting for someone, y'all. He's a lion, thief, and rattlesnake, and he's broken every law. He's terrorized the lives of men, and he's under arrest because I've been sent with a warrant from the body of Christ. Satan, bite the dust. One of you unclean spirits, I'm running you out of town. Depression, strife, disease, and fear, your posse's going down.
Oh, last dinner for the dog, Batman. We sent him over the box.
But I know who I am through Jesus Christ, so I talk to you demons like dogs. Satan, you coward, you molester of souls, I command you to appear. You're hiding from the presence of God, but I can feel your fear from here.
You rattle my keyboard long enough, you got something in your craw.
A praying church wants you to know.
Know what?
Your kingdom's gonna fall.
There's gonna be trouble here tonight.
Cause I represent a whole new breed of Christian of today. And I'm authorized and deputized to blow you clean away. A message to deliver from one who's true and just. We'll spit in your eye, you father of lies. Satan, bite the dust.
Boy, you gonna take me on in my unholy herd?
Not only take you on, but take you out by the Spirit and the Word. One by one you'll drop like flies underfoot and in the ground, because greater is he who is in me than the snake I'm staring down. You demon of alcoholism, you'll be the first to go. There's deliverance from you through Jesus Christ, so hit the road. You spirit of infirmity, you ain't welcome here no more. We lay hands on the sick and they recover, so out the door. You demon of false religion, you've preyed on minds so simple. I bind the spirit of your song, so now come on!
play that in your temple. Now, Satan, you're next in line. I'm gonna hit you where it hurts. Cause I'm tired of you and my family. And I'm tired of you and my church. I'm not my own, I'm bought with a price. I'm a Holy Ghost-filled man. And I'm tolling the bell of your eternal destruction across the land. Cause I represent a whole new breed of Christian of today. And I'm authorized and deputized to blow you clean away. I've got a weapon with two bullets that overcome all sin and crud. One bullet is called the word of my testimony, and the other one's called the blood. Satan, bite the dust. Bite the dust. Well, how do you feel about that, devil?
I'm a feeling mighty low.
Good.
Amen and amen and amen. That's another one by Carmen. Amen, devil. Bite the dust. Amen. But I'm telling you, it is time. It's time for us to rise up. Amen. It's time for us to put the devil where he belongs. It's time for us to take the churches back in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the only begotten Son of God. Amen. It's no longer is it time to sit on the sidelines and not do anything about it. My God, we're in the end time battle. We're in the real deal. It's time to suit up. Get ready. Let's go. Either with or without you. Amen. This battle's happening. It's going to happen. Either you're going to be on the winning side or you're going to be on the losing side. There's no in between today, my friends. You got to make your mind up and get suited up. Amen. Choose this day whom you're going to serve. Like when Moses threw the line in the dirt. Those of you on God's side, step on this side, and the rest stay over there, because you're about to be slaughtered by the almighty hand of God. Can you hear what's going on? Do you understand what's happening in today's world? Amen. That we're going to take this gospel to this United States of America, and we're going to cry loud and spare not, and we're not going to slow down. We're not going to back up. We're not going to give in. Amen. We're going to call the devil out. We're going to call him out for what he truly is. Amen. And let the world know, hey, these false religions are going to send you to hell. Hey, this sin you're living in going to send you to hell. Hey, the only way you can escape the fiery damnation from the pit of hell is through Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Not the false Jesus Christ that man made that says you can still serve sin and serve him. Not the false Jesus Christ that they teach about in all these so-called churches. My God, we're talking about the real deal. Amen. We're talking about the real deal. It's time to get suited up. It's time to get armored up. It's time. Amen. It's time. But give this testimony right here a listen, all right, for a minute, and be blessed. Amen.
The Holy Spirit really put this on my heart to make. It's not a message of any sort. It's kind of a testimony, I guess you would say. Back in 2002, I asked Jesus into my heart. I did the sinner's prayer and asked him into my heart. But I kept sinning. I kept fornicating. I kept drinking. I kept on doing sin. So I thought I was saved. I went to church. I would go to church every Sunday. And then I would, you know, continue to go to church every Sunday and listen to the word. And I started to change. I stopped cussing. I stopped taking God's name in vain. And I started to be kind. I started to be kinder and loving towards people. But like I said, I was still fornicating, I was still drinking and doing drugs. But like I said, I've done the sinner's prayer, and every time I would watch a program, I would say the sinner's prayer over again. And I never really felt any change. And then in 2004, when I went to Iraq for war, I was baptized in Euphrates. And even then, I still would sin. I still would fornicate. Well, no, I was married at the time. I didn't fornicate, but I was still drinking. and I was still sinning, willingly sinning against God. I hadn't received the gift of the baptism of the Holy Spirit at all, I guess, because maybe my heart wasn't in a true repentance, but I would say the sinner's prayer. And for 10 years I lived like this. For 10 years I lived the same life, drinking and smoking weed, and started smoking cigarettes again. And yeah, I didn't cuss. I'd go to church. I'd go on even Wednesdays. I would go to Bible studies, different Bible studies at people's houses and women's Bible studies. And I mean, I'd be in church and raise my hand and praising God. But then I'd go home and I'd sin. And I'd drink and party like the world. So I never got a clear understanding of what being saved was. That to me wasn't, you know, saved, but I mean, I thought it was. I looked like the world. I looked like the other Christians that were sitting in church with me. They were doing the same thing. I mean, cause a lot of them were my friends, but then, you know, I seen other families that I weren't around a lot, but they would be the same way that I was, but who knows what was happening in their homes, you know, on the side. And I even was in a women's group, a women's Bible study. And we were sitting there and we were praying. And the women started praying with tongues. And I asked one of the older ladies, I was like, you know, what is that? What are you guys doing? And she said, it's we're praying in the Spirit. And it's part of the, you know, the Holy Spirit. When you have the Holy Spirit, which you have in you, to pray this way. And I said, well, I don't. And she said, well, just keep on saying the same thing over and praying faster and faster and it'll come out. Okay, so I started to, and then it, you know, came out. But it was false. It was a lie. It wasn't tongues. It was just, you can't be, that's something you can't teach somebody. I learned later on. It comes from the Holy Spirit living in you, being baptized with the Holy Spirit. It's even in Scripture that I don't know what scripture, Acts, and it's in Acts, but it's when you give the gift of the Holy Spirit, you speak in utterance. It's a prayer language between you and the Heavenly Father, because the Spirit knows what the Holy Spirit knows what you need. So it's your prayer language to the Father. So it's nothing you can learn or somebody to tell you to do over and over and hey, and you know, it'll come out this way. So that was false. So for 10 years, I lived like this, thinking I was saved and going to church and doing everything to, you know, try to change in the flesh. And it never worked. It never worked. I still fall to other different, if you see my other testimonies, you see that I went to the New Age kind of stuff. And I was into that and thinking that was part of God and part of Jesus. And I would still pray, and I would still thought I was saved, seeking the Lord, but yeah, I looked like the world. And so I never separated myself. I just kept on going on with my business, going to church and thinking I was saved. And every now and then I'd say the sinner's prayer over, you know, just to make sure. And I guess it wasn't a true repentance. God knows our heart. He knows a true repentance. When we say that prayer, He knows whose heart's real. He can't come into his temple, his holy temple that he calls holy. He can't come in there if it's not true and it's filthy with sin. I'm living proof of that. He didn't come in at all. I mean, I thought he was there because everybody says when you say the sinner's prayer, you are automatically, you know, get the Holy Spirit. Okay, and so I just never felt any different. And I would listen to other people say how much of a change, and they stopped drinking and smoking and doing drugs, and it totally changed them. And I'm thinking to myself, I never had that experience. Why isn't that happening to me? Why am I not getting that? And so I would read scripture here and there, and like I said, go to church, and I'd raise my hands and be like on my knees singing and praising the Lord, and then go home and pop open a 40 and drink. And so it was all wrong. I didn't have the Holy Spirit. I wasn't saved. God told me. It wasn't until September of 2012 when I started seeking Him with my whole heart seeking Him and crying out. And he changed me. He took those desires of drinking and smoking cigarettes, I mean smoking weed, out of my life right instantly. And I started seeking him more. He told me I was on my way to hell. I wasn't saved. And so I started seeking him with my whole heart. And then December 22nd, 2012, is when I received the wonderful, glorious gift, the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And I stopped smoking cigarettes that day and never had a desire. And my whole heart changed in it. And I became a new creature in Christ. And I don't sin. I separated myself from the world. I don't have any of those desires whatsoever, even to sin. And even if I do sin without, not willingly, but if I sin without knowing it's sin, something happens, the Holy Spirit will convict me and I'll ask for forgiveness and I'll repent. But not willingly like I used to. I used to willingly sin and think I was going to heaven. And it's not true. And there's so much scripture to back it up. And I'm not really looking into that right now. And I can if, anybody asks or anything. But I'm just telling you that I'm living proof that there's so many people out there that just play church and think they're saved and don't know about the gift of the Holy Spirit, that they need that in them to change them. I would read the scripture about being free from sin and all the other things, and I'd be like, well, I'm not. What's going on? It's because I didn't have the gift of the Holy Spirit working in me to change my heart, to live in me. And so now I do, and I know the difference. And like I said, for 10 years, I thought, hey, I'm saved. And I would even say the sinner's prayer over so many times over that last 10 years and go to church and do all the things that I would see and think I was saved. And wonder why when I talked about the Lord to people, nobody ever got saved. It's because I was a hypocrite. So I just wanted to share that with you. So really, check yourself, and just because you're going to church and you might have said the sinner's prayer, make sure you have the gift of the Holy Spirit, the true, it's part of the Godhead, it's the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, it's three in one. Just make sure you have that in you so that you do, it changes you. It's not just something you read in the Bible about. I mean, that, okay, I have the Holy Spirit and think that you have it. Ask for that gift, and the gift of the Holy Spirit, knowing that you have it, is the utterance to speak in tongues. And when I received that Holy Spirit, I spoke in tongues. And it was different than from what I was practiced, kept on doing and thought I was. And I repented. I asked, for forgiveness, because falsely doing it is, I've read so many things how bad that is up against God I don't know what it was, but it was in tongues. It wasn't until I received the gift of the Holy Spirit. So I just wanted to share that and tell you that I love you all, and I'm praying for you, and God bless you, and Jesus loves you. And if you don't know Jesus, ask him into your heart and ask the Holy Spirit to come and live in your heart. Yes, baby. Mommy, yes, say hi.
Hi.
Say Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you.
Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Amen and amen and amen. Is that not a testimony? Amen. I'm telling you. But that's the whole point of that whole testimony right there. People think they're living the right life and they're not. See, they're caught into that false religion. Amen. They're caught into what the devil has created people to believe from the main beginning with Adam and Eve. My God, is you can do what you want and not have a consequence for it. That you can still be saved and serve God and still do what you want to do too. And it's a lie straight from the pit of hell that's got caught up almost every church building they are in the United States. I don't know about outside the United States. I ain't there, but I'm here, and I assume it's all over the world. But I know God's called me, chose me, and purposed me for the United States of America, amen, to go around and to preach his gospel, amen, to take his gospel out here, to not be ashamed, amen, to call the devil out, to call these false religions out, to call the sin out, amen, and to try to help open people's eyes and bring them to the true living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, amen, the God of the Bible, amen, the true repentance. You can't just say the sinner's prayer and be saved, amen. You've got to mean it from your heart. You've got to really be a separated people. You've got to really come out from amongst the world. Amen. You can't keep pertaining of the things of the world and pertain of the things of the Spirit. You've got to make your mind up and choose this day whom you serve. Amen. Because we're going to battle. We're in war. Amen. Whoever wants to jump in this battle, my God, jump in it. Amen. But be suited up. Be ready. Be prepared. But count that cost. Unless you get out here and you got to turn and tuck tail and retreat because you didn't count the cost. Because the cost is going to be great, my friend, in the ways of the world. It's going to be great. Amen. You're going to have to give up some things. You're going to have to do without some things. But what you get back in return for being in the Lord's army, my God, is incomparable to. Amen. We're talking about walking on streets of gold, my God, crowns of righteousness. Lord, have mercy. We're talking about getting to be with God Almighty, the Almighty Creator of heaven and earth for eternity. Amen. We're talking about He's gonna keep us right there with Him. My God, how good and glorious that day is going to be. Amen. And that's what we work towards. That's what we work for. Amen. Keeping that hope. Keeping that faith. Amen. But we've got to understand that we are chosen. We are prepared for this last day battle. We are in the last days, my friend. If you don't believe that, you're in trouble already. Amen. We are in this battle. Whether you like it or don't like it, you in it. And you got to make a decision. You got to cross that line today. Amen. Today is the day of salvation. You've got to make your mind up. Cross that line. Either you on God's side or you on the world's side. And let me tell you something. The world going to be destroyed. Amen. The devil and his angels are going to be locked into hell. Amen. They're going to be sent to hell. So if you choose to be on their side, that's where you're going. Amen. You choose to be on their side, God's going to call you out. Amen. He's going to call you out. And that's what He's chose us to do as the children of God, the true born again baptized believers, baby. We coming forth with the truth, with the word of God. Amen. We ain't going to slow down. We ain't going to back down. We ain't going sideways. You see, the old devil tries to throw things out there for you to stumble over, to slow you down, to keep this from happening, to keep that from happening. My God, stay prayed up. Stay fasted up. Cause suit up. Cause baby, here we go. Amen. We ain't got time to sit on the sidelines. We ain't got time to worry about what people care, what people think. We ain't got time. Because it's the time. It's the time of the great battle. We are in that time. It is the end days. This great spiritual battle is going and going and going. And my God, make a decision on whose side you on today. Amen. Let's get suited up. Let's get ramped up. Let's get excited for the kingdom of God. Let's go out and do God's work. Forget about what you want. Forget about yourself. And let's let God's will be done in our life. Let's be that great army, amen, for the Lord. Hey, good God Almighty, let's get fired up. Let's get on fire for God, amen. Let's get on fire for God. Let's go out here and win souls over to God for the kingdom of God, amen, for the glory of God. Let's help people get introduced to this man named Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Let's go out and lay hands on the sick and let's get them healed in Jesus' name. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hey, God's gave us the power when we chose to believe it. Amen. God gave us the power to be sons and daughters of Him. Amen. Sons and daughters. My God, we are joint heirs of the kingdom of God, joint heirs of Jesus Christ. Amen. We got the power. Christ has given us the power and He's sending us forth to do His work. And it's time that we mount up. It's time that we rise up and mount that horse of righteousness, baby, and ride it into the promised land. Amen. Ride it into the promised land. Because we're going to start a great revival in these United States of America, my God, that is going to shake its foundations, amen. Because we're going to go out and we're going to call the devil out, amen. And we're going to preach the truth and the word of God, amen. The true word of God sets the captives free, amen. We're going after them. We're going to call the devil out and we're going to bring people out of the darkness and into the everlasting good God kingdom of light, amen.
In the center of the caverns of hell, hidden under layers of evil that have thrived for centuries, sets the morbid domain of the prince of the power of the air. Suddenly, a scaly creature disrupts Satan's ghastly existence with an urgent message, and it reads,
dread problem. Confidence needed. Disaster forecasted. With a disgusted annoyance, this general of evil agrees to confer with his chief demon lieutenant. This is the story of that encounter.
You may enter.
My lord, Satan.
State your business and make it fast.
Sir, we're having problems of cataclysmic proportions.
Where?
In the east sector, sir. The damage is vast.
Is there something wrong with my abortion clinics?
Well, no, sir. That's all fine. We kill 4,000 unborn a day through, shall we say, surgical removal?
Good.
It's selective breeding. We eliminate human life in the name of convenience, like the Nazis and the Jews and with the government's approval.
Is there a problem with my pet project, television violence?
Sir, it's covered from videos to cartoons. By the time a child graduates high school, he's seen 70,000 murders.
Is this effective enough?
Sir, just watch the news.
Is there a disturbance in my false religion?
Oh, no, sir. Business is booming. Over 40 million are into New Age and Zen. Over 45 million believe in astrology.
Looks like we are catching up.
Yes, sir. Only 50 million claim to be born again.
Is there a problem with business in general?
Sir, we're showing tremendous progress.
Yeah.
Teenage runaways, each year a million or more. There's a teen suicide every 90 minutes. And your specialty, drunk driving, will claim more lives this year than the whole Vietnam War.
Well, is there a disturbance in... What was that?
Sir, that's the reason all these demons are on crutches and wobbling.
What's going on?
Sir, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
What is that?
Sir, that is our problem.
Only one thing causes warfare of this magnitude.
Then, sir, you know what we are dealing with up there.
Yes, it's some of those sanctified...
tri-blood-bought...
spirit-filled...
saints of God...
actually...
presently on their knees...
in prayer.
Sir, they're literal holy terrors. They bind us, cast us out. Then they do those disgusting charismatic jigs. They quote scriptures like the Son of God. And sir, if you don't intervene, we all might wind up in a bunch of pigs. Sir, that's the good news. The bad news is the subject of their prayers that threatens our survival. What they're praying for is causing hemorrhaging in the realms of darkness.
The bad news is...
sir... they're praying for revival!
I hate revival. It just erupts. It's hardly controllable. At the Azusa Street outpouring, things got rough.
Yes, sir. And when the charismatic movement hit, sir, we were jumping out of windows. With all of that, untie my bow tie. Who stole my hand this stuff?
Then I'll come in like a flood.
But they'll say the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against you. It's written in the Word.
I'll form weapons against them.
Sir, no weapon formed against them shall prosper. That's in the Bible, too.
Yes, I've heard. I'll hit them with every filthy, lusty thought you can imagine.
But it's written, resist the devil and he must flee.
Obviously, the enemy is taking the battle more seriously than we are.
And that's very dangerous, sir. Especially for me.
Time to launch my final vicious attack. I'll remind the saints of their past. How they were liars, cheaters, manipulators, and mooters.
But sir, you know what will happen if you remind the saints of their past.
And what is that?
Sir, they'll just remind you of your future.
No!
Attention all saints of God!
Is rising up.
Amen and amen and amen. Revival in the land. Amen. Because the devil truly fears the name of Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Amen. And when we truly get lined up with God, when we truly get our lives fixed with God, when we truly get blood bought, born again, saints of God with the power of God. Amen. We're going to put the devil on the run, baby. We're going to call him out. Amen. But we got to get blood bought. We got to get born again. We got to get suited up. We got to get armored up. My God, we've got to step forward on the front line of the battlefield today. Amen. We've got to care about people enough to march right in, baby, and not fear what they can do to us, but fear what God can do to us. Amen. We've got to know without a shadow of a doubt that we're being led by the hand of God. We've got to know beyond a shadow of a doubt that we've got the power of God. And that's what's wrong with most people today. That's what's wrong with most churches today. Is they say they believe in God, but they deny the power thereof. My God, the same power that resurrected Jesus Christ from the dead is the same power that's in us. Amen. He's the same God for yesterday, today, and forevermore. My God, what's happened to God's people? Amen. They have become lazy bones. They have become complainers, whiners, criers, little babies that need pacifiers stuck in their mouth. My God, get the pacifier out of your mouth and get some meat in there. Get the Word of God in there. Grow up in the Spirit of God. Let's begin to walk in that Spirit of God and not in the flesh. And then we're going to see the power of God. Amen. Then we're going to see what God can do. Then we're going to realize that we are nothing without Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's get suited up, guys. Let's get armored up. Let's really begin to pray. Really begin to fast. Really begin to call the devil out. My God, let's take God all across these United States because God dwells in us. Amen. He dwells in us. And we, everywhere we go, we take him with us. Amen. The power and the resurrection of Jesus Christ lives in us. Now let's take it to the lost and dying world. Amen. Let's take it to the lost and dying world. My God, it's time that we learn. It's time that we believe what we say we really believe in. Woo, I'm telling you. I want to read a little bit here out of, be starting in, I done lost my place. All right, 2 Peter, we'll be starting in 2 Peter chapter 1, starting at verse 19. 2 Peter chapter 1, starting at verse 19, and we're going to go through into chapter 2 here some. And but we're starting at 2 Peter chapter 1, starting at verse 18. 19, I'm sorry. 1 Peter chapter 1, starting at verse 19, says, "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place until the day dawn and the day star rise in your hearts. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the Scripture is of any private interpretation. But the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but by holy men of God, spoke as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. But there were false prophets also amongst the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privately shall bring in damnable heresies, and denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. And many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And through covetousness shall they with feigned words make merchandise of you, whose judgment now of a long time lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. For if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell, and delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment, and spared not the old world, but saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly, and delivered just Lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked." For that righteous man dwelling among them, and seeing and hearing vexed his righteous soul from day to day with their unlawful deeds. The Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptations, and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. But chiefly them that walk after the flesh and the lust of uncleanness and despise governments, presumptuous are they, self-willed. They are not afraid to speak evil of dignities, whereof angels, which are greater in power and might, bring not railing accusations against them before the Lord. But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption, and shall receive the reward of unrighteousness, as they count it pleasure to ride in the daytime. Spots they are and blemishes, sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with you. Having eyes full of adultery, and that cannot cease from sin. Be guilty, unstable souls, and heart they have exercised with covetous practices, cursed children. Amen. These are the people having eyes full of adultery that cannot cease from sin. They can't help but to sin. I know you've heard people, I can't help but to sin. I'm in the flesh. You got that much right. You living in the flesh and not in the spirit. And let me tell you something. If you ain't walking in the spirit of God, then you don't got the spirit of God. Can somebody say amen? Lord, have mercy almighty. Listen to me. If you are willfully sinning, my friend, then you are in trouble. You know why? Because if you keep willfully sinning, that means you don't got the spirit of God. We're going to break it down. We're going to like mark it down with some crayons here for you. All right. My God, listen to the word of God. Listen to the word of God. Amen. Listen to the word of God. The word of God says that you must be born again. The word of God says the truth shall make you free. Amen. But you got to accept the truth. You got to come out from amongst these false religions. You've got to come out from amongst the way your mommy and daddy taught you. You've got to come out from amongst the way your uncle lived. You've got to come out from amongst the way you've taught yourself in your own mind. And you've got to come over to God's way. Amen. You've got to really accept his word, really accept the truth, really do some repenting in your life, some crying out. Some true repentance means you would turn away from, you'll be sorry of, you won't want to keep doing those things, amen. But you got to get ready. You better get ready. You better get suited up. You better put on the full armor of God, my friend, because this world's getting worse, amen, and it's going to get worse. They got, see, the people, they bring in teachers for their own selves to scratch their itching ears. That's what people do, amen, because they don't want to hear the truth. The people that ain't got the truth, which is the Spirit of God, they don't want to hear the truth from the Spirit of God. So they bring in people that don't have the Spirit of God to teach them about the worldly ways, because they think it's all right to pretend, live in pretend land and go ahead and leave the church and go ahead and sin as much as they want, and they still going to be saved because they said the sinner's prayer and blah, 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 blah. It's all garbage and trash, my friends. Open your eyes. Listen to the word of God. Listen to the spirit of God. Amen. And I'm telling you, these people out here that say they know God and they don't know him. Amen. These people that claim to be Christians and they're not saved. Amen. These people that claim to be prophets and they're false. Amen. Open your eyes, people. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Amen. I'm talking about your spiritual eyes. I'm talking about opening up your heart. My God, we can't live in the carnal mind no more. The carnal mind is enmity against God. Wipe it out. Get rid of it. Die daily. Pick up your cross and follow after Christ. Because we in a war, my God. We in a war. And the war is more real than anything that you can see with your natural eye today, my friend. It is real, and there are people dying in this spiritual war. They're getting slaughtered by the dozens, by the enemy out here, because the people of God won't stand up, because the people of God are afraid of the devil, because people of God has got sin in their life, and they know they're polluted, and they know they're guilty, and they won't fix it. My God, get it fixed today. Get it under the blood, my friend, and let's get mounted up. Amen, on this horse of righteousness. Let's put on the full armor of God. Let's make sure we got our sword, which is the word of God, and let's go to battle, baby. Amen. Amen. Let's get suited up. Let's get ready. Let's go to this battle. Let's go after these lost souls. Let's go take back what the devil done took, amen, because he ain't got the power or the authority, amen. We got to put him under our foot. We got to call the devil out. Amen. But how can you call the devil out? By the power and the authority of Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. That's how you call him out. We can't call him out in herself. Yourself better die. Yourself better get out of the way. Yourself better learn to be subjective to the Spirit of God. Amen. That's how you're going to call the devil out of your house. That's how you're going to call the devil out of your family. That's how you're going to call the devil out of your own soul. It's through Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Until then, you're going to lay around and mumble and complain and roll around in your own self-filth and be licking on your own crap. But you don't got to. You don't got to. My God, you can get suited up, armored up, come to know the only true living God. And you can be fired up. You can be set on fire, a light for this world that is set upon a hill that the world can't help but to see, my God, because Jesus Christ truly lives in you and he's truly shining out. And you'll be a separated people and you'll look insane to this world. But my God, we will look insane to this world when we're sold out to God. We will look insane to this world. They will make fun of us. They will persecute us. They will put us down. They will lock us in prison. But you know what? It don't matter, my God, because God's will's going to be done in his children's life today. Can somebody say amen? So come on, let's get on fire for God, and let's let the world see Jesus Christ in us. Amen. Let's really, 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 really be blood bought. Really, 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 really be born again. Really, really, really let God have control of your life today, my friend, and people won't know what took place. They'll say you insane, but you know what they will say? They'll know that it's God in you. You know why? Because even the devil knows. Even the devil knows and trembles. Amen. People know. And they don't like the light. They like the darkness rather than light. Why? Because the light reproves them. The light brings out the sin. Amen. And the people, you'll find the people that really truly know God and really striving to be Christ-like, they like that light. They want to come to the light. Why? Because they don't want sin in their life. They want to get right with God. They want to be on fire for God. But then you got the hypocrites, the so-called wannabes, could-bes, and should-bes. My God, that say one thing and do another. They run from the light. They will run from the light because they don't want their deeds made known. They don't want everybody to see what they truly do because they're liars and whoremongers and hypocrites. But today is the day that they're going to be called out. Amen. Today is the day that the devil is getting called out. Because Jesus Christ is the Lord of lords and King of kings. My Lord, have mercy. I'm telling you, they're getting ready to be a move that sweeps this United States of America. At first, it's bad because America has turned its back on God. Because America is worshiping false idols. Because America don't know the difference between God and a piece of dirt out there. My God, something's wrong with that. But to the flip side of that is God's raising up an army. Oh, yes, my Lord. He's raising up a people that ain't ashamed. He's raising up a people that are going to stand on his name. He's raising up a people that are blood-bought, born again, sanctified, and set free, baby. And we're going out in here into these United States of America, and we preaching God's word. And we're going to call the devil out. We're going to call him out for what he is. Amen. Because truly, God is raising up a people. Woo, good God Almighty, that is fired up and filled up.
I got a smile on my face, a little dance in my step. Folks think I want some money, but they ain't got it yet. All around the local town, they're starting to inquire. I got fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Hey, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that Ted revival came up from hearts are changing, even their desire, getting fired up and filled up with that Holy Ghost power. Some folks got so excited, they ran all the way back home.
when the whole place started shaking. Need the power of the Lord. Miracles and wonders lasted for hours. They got fired up and fueled up with that Holy Ghost power. Yeah, see, things sure are different, like we've never seen ever since that tent revival came up from Aberdeen. People's hearts are changing, even their desire, getting fired up and fueled up with that Holy Ghost power.
Amen and amen. Ain't God good? Amen. I'm telling you, God is so good all the time. Amen. I tell you, I'm fired up and filled up. Amen. I'm fired up. Amen and filled up. I told everybody a long time ago, a while back, you know, I even said a few times over the jukebox right here, I'm telling you that God has told me to call this sin out. Amen. And that to make the sin known. I'm telling you this. And he said that people was going to hate me, that they was really going to revolt me. They was going to hate my guts because I'm going to call the sin sin. Amen. But I'm going to do what God says to do. I can't help it if the whole world don't like me and hates me and comes against me. I got one that is on my side that will lead me into heaven almighty, that will hold my hand and won't ever let go. Amen. He won't ever let go. He won't ever let go. So I'm going to call the sin out. I'm going to go forth and do what God's told me to do. I'm going to obey God and not man. I'm going to do what God's told me to do. Amen. And it's time. It's time for us to realize who we are in Jesus Christ. It's time for us to understand the power that God has given us as the children of God. Amen. It's time to rise up. Time to rise up. Amen. Time to rise up. Let's get suited up, people. Let's get on fire for God. Let's put on that full armor. Come on. We are in this battle. Let's go to this battle. Let's go forth as the shining bright light, amen, that we are in Jesus Christ. And let's let the world see it, amen. Let's let the world see it. Because truly, it's all about Jesus Christ and not about us. Amen. So let's let God be God. Amen. Let God be God in your life. Amen. And everything will be all right. Amen. It may not make sense. You may not understand it, but we don't need to understand. God's ways is above our ways. Amen. Because what God's got in plan for your life, just let God's will be done in your life. Amen. Because I'm telling you, it's time that we mount up, that we suit up, that we get ready, that we stay prepared. My God, that we fight this spiritual fight with every fiber in our being that God has given us to do. Amen. That he has put it in us, my God, the power to put the serpents under her feet. Amen. No longer to be afraid of them, be scared of them. It's time to walk in with the authority of God and set things right. Amen. Amen.
One peaceful afternoon, I picked up from my mailbox the strangest looking letter I'd ever seen. A chilling little envelope bordered with flying bats and eerie serpents whose eyes were tinted green. Now, the letter was addressed to me, so as I opened it, I froze. What I read turned my complexion three shades of blue. It said, "My name is Isaac Horowitz. I'm a male witch, a warlock. Feel I need to spend some time with you." Now, as a Christian from a little church with God's call on my life, a man of faith and power with a challenge to grow, I did what any saint would do in my situation. I tore it up so there wasn't a way I'm gonna go. Then gently and methodically, the Holy Spirit spoke and reminded me we're God's voice to our nation. It's the church's responsibility to witness. So reluctantly, I accepted this witch's invitation. He had the house you'd expect, the old English cottage, a Nightmare on Elm Street special right to the core, the overgrown ivy, the gate that creaked when opened. Somehow you'd expect Freddy to answer this door. The doorbell rang, a hollow gong. The knob twisted, then opened. And Isaac stood before me with a grin. His jet black hair and well-trimmed beard flowed with his black silk clothes. My skin crawled as he said, "Please, come on in." His house was filled with every occultic symbol you could fathom. Hanging pentagrams, horoscope signs, a Ouija board and Dungeons and Dragons games set on the table, a crystal ball with an incandescent shine. And graciously, he handed me some steaming herbal tea. Its presence caused my memory to jog. I thought of every horror flick I'd seen when I was a kid and thought, man, you drink this stuff, next day you'll be a frog. Then he led me to a high back chair as he meticulously began to unfold his scenario with evil patience. I was given a giant leather-bound book jammed with newspaper clippings, thus the reason for this witch's invitation. With eagerness, he pointed to each article with pride. He said, "I healed this woman through a Babylonian chant. You see, this man, I cured him while performing druid worship. I was paid to curse this man with AIDS by his aunt." On and on, page after page, delightfully he flaunted each incident for an hour without a breath. He said, "Do you realize through my understanding of the dark regions that I can make you rich or even curse someone to death?" I sat literally intimidated by his immensity and demon power, while his face shone with a satanic arrogant bliss. Then, placing his hands on the arms of my chair and leaning into my face, he said, "What can your God do to compete with this?" I knew then how Moses felt when his rod turned to a serpent, and the three Egyptian magicians did the same. It's as if you're sitting there in that stunned moment where your faith gets violated, and all you feel is weak, powerless, and lame. I desperately and deeply prayed, saying, "Jesus, give me wisdom. I don't want to put you through some foolish test." Then a shaft of light shot through my soul, igniting my eyes with fire. God stood me up, and I threw the book back in his chest. I said, "Isaac, I'll not compare God's miracles versus Satan's. The issue's not God's kingdom at Satan's lair. The real comparison is the condition of your soul and the condition of mine. And you puppet of the devil, that I will compare. I said, my friend, one day they're coming for you. The soft associates in your incantations, the friendly demons you think you now control. The time will come when you'll be lying in bed, wheezing like a dying animal, when those spirits lay claim to the rights they own to your soul. Then the room will grow dark, and the most hideous evil faces you've ever seen will come flaming out of the floor with a yell. The vile informants that promised reincarnation will claw your spirit and victoriously drag your soul to hell. Then I grab the book and says, in that moment, which mantra, which incantation are you going to chant to tell them to leave you alone? I said, my friend, I know beyond a shadow of a doubt what I would say. I am bought with the blood of Jesus. Let me go. I said, Isaac, when you tossed that book in my lap, you gloated with a sinister victory. You rejoiced when you saw your name in black and white. Now I rejoice, but not that your council of demons are subject to Jesus, but that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Then Isaac jumped up from his chair and screamed, you must leave now! I said, I will, but one last obligation. Next time, think twice before you rumble with a man of God. By the way, thanks for your witch's invitation.
Amen, amen. We've got to let the light of God shine, amen, in the darkest of darkest places, amen. We've got to let them shine again, amen. We've got to let them shine again. We've got to let that light shine, amen, again and again and again and again and again, amen, through Jesus Christ, amen and amen. God is good. Well, I'm going to jump off here, guys. I'm going to tune it out. Amen. But know this. Know that God loves you. Amen. Know that I love you. And know that we need to get suited up, battled up, raised up, resurrected through Jesus Christ Almighty, because there's a war going on. Amen. And we need to be on the front line. Amen. We need to be ready. We need to be prepared. Amen. And let's get suited up and mounted up. And let's take revival to the United States of America. Again, amen, amen. Come on, let's go call the devil out with the authority of God, amen. And let's let people know and see that bright shining light of Jesus Christ shining through us, amen, amen.
With the Samsung Radiant 360, music reaches your ears the same way no matter where you are in the room. So if the music always goes your way, it leaves one to wonder what else might. The Samsung Radiant 360. Live in the sweet spot.
George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Samuel Adams, First Chief Justice John Jay. Names synonymous with the spirit of our country. Founding fathers of the USA. Over 200 years ago, they shook off the chains of tyranny from Great Britain by divine call. Citing 27 biblical violations, they wrote the Declaration of Independence with liberty and justice for all. But something happened since Jefferson called the Bible the cornerstone for American liberty, then put it in our schools as a light. Or since Give Me Liberty or Give Me Death, Patrick Henry said, our country was founded on the gospel of Jesus Christ. We eliminated God from the equation of American life, thus eliminating the reason this nation first began. From beyond the grave, I hear the voices of our founding fathers plead. You need God in America again. Of the 55 men who formed the Constitution, 52 were active members of their church. Founding fathers like Noah Webster, who wrote the first dictionary, could literally quote the Bible chapter and verse. James Madison said, "We've staked our future and our ability to follow the Ten Commandments with all our heart." These men believed you couldn't even call yourself an American if you subvert the Word of God. In his farewell address, Washington said, "You can't have national morality apart from religious principle," and it's true. Because right now we have nearly 150,000 kids carrying guns to these war zones we call public schools. In the 40s and 50s, student problems were chewing gum and talking. In the 90s, rape and murder are the trend. The only way this nation can even hope to last this decade is put God in America again.
The only hope for America is Jesus. The only hope for our country is Him. If we repent of our ways, stand firm and say,
Abe Lincoln said, "The philosophy of the schoolroom in one generation will be the philosophy of government in the next." So when you eliminate the Word of God from the classroom and politics, you eliminate the nation that Word protects. America is now number one in teen pregnancy and violent crime, number one in illiteracy, drug use, and divorce. Every day a new Holocaust of 5,000 unborn die, while pornography floods our streets like open sewers. America's dead and dying hand is on the threshold of the church, while the spirit of Sodom and Gomorrah vex us all. When it gets to the point where people would rather come out of the closet than clean it, it's the sign that judgment of God is gonna fall. If there's ever been a time to rise up, church, it's now. And as the blood-bought saints of the living God proclaim, that it's time to sound the alarm from the church house to the White House and say, we want God in America again. I believe it's time, America, to stand up and proclaim that one nation under God is our demand, and send this evil lifestyle back to Satan where it came from, and let the Word of God revive our dying land. For Jesus Christ is coming back again in all His glory, and every eye shall see Him on that day. That's why a new anointing of God's power is coming on us to boldly tell the world you must be saved. Because astrology won't save you, your horoscope won't save you. The Bible says these things are all a farce. If you're born again, you don't need to look to the stars for your answers, because you can look to the very one who made those stars. History tells us time and time again, to live like there's no God makes you a fool. If you want to see kids live right, stop handing out condoms and start handing out the Word of God in school.
Amen and amen. We need God in America again. Amen. Brother Philip on here says, "Hi, all, love all. God bless. Had a great day in the Lord. Bless, praise God." Amen, brother. Did you get your baptism done, brother? Amen. Amen. I'm glad, brother. I'm glad. I'm glad you're on fire. I'm glad God's in your heart, in your life, brother, and in your mind. Amen. I'm glad. Amen. I'm telling you, this program been all about calling the devil out. Amen. About getting suited up, putting on that full armor, and let's go out here into these United States of America, my God, and let's call the devil out. Let's call sin out by the power and authority of Jesus Christ. We are marching forth into this nation in one mind, one accord, with Jesus Christ being the chief head of us all. Amen. And we're going to call sin out, and we're going to call the devil out, because we've counted the cost. We know what it takes. Amen. And it takes us dying daily. It takes us picking up the cross and following after Christ. No more sitting beside the sidelines. No more sitting at home not caring about it. It's time now, because we in the end times. It's time now, because God says so. He said it's time. Amen. It's time to rise up with the authority and the boldness of Jesus Christ, and to go across this land and take revival all across this United States of America. Amen. And it's time that we rise up with Jesus Christ. Amen. It's time. Amen and amen. I'm telling you, God is good. Amen. God is good, good, good all the time. Man, I'm telling you, I'm just so on fire, so amazed, you know, by God. He just blows my mind. Amen. Oh, he just blows my mind. Amen. God is good all the time. Amen. Amen and amen. Amen and amen and amen. I'm telling you now, we're going across this great land, United States of America. Amen. Preaching the gospel, taking that bright and shining light of Jesus Christ to the lost and dying. Amen. We're going forth with the boldness and the authority of Jesus Christ. Amen. So jump on board or jump out of the way. Makes no difference. Amen. But wherever you at, know this, that you need to get on fire for God. Amen. That you need to get suited up, mounted up, and let's get to work for the kingdom of God. Amen. Let's get to work for the kingdom of God. Amen. And let's get a heart for God. Amen. Let's really get that heart to want to do the work of God. Amen. To want to really get on fire for God. Amen. Amen. I'm telling you, God is good. Amen. God is good. Philip said, the devil is mad as hell is hot because he just lost another soul. I am glad to say that I don't care. Amen, brother. Amen and amen and amen and amen and amen. I'm telling you, I'm so excited. Amen. So excited. I just can't hide it. Amen. Amen. Amen and amen. But guys, we're going to say that we love you, that we're always praying for you. Amen. I always ask you to keep us in prayer. Amen. I always ask you to pray that God's will be done in our life. But know one thing without a shadow of a doubt. Amen. That God is the only true living God, the God of Abraham and Isaac, of the Holy Bible, and his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, is the only way you're going to make it to heaven. Amen. And that is for sure. That is for sure. But let's get on fire for God. Let's get excited. And let's take this revival to the United States of America. Amen. So that souls can be revived. Amen. Amen and amen. I'm telling you, God is good. Amen. God is good. Oh, I get so excited. I'm telling you, I just can't help it. Amen. So excited, just can't help it. But as you listen to this song, we're going to say, hey, we love you. We're praying for you. Amen. And just always, always stay in God's word. Amen. Do what God would have you to do. Get in the army of the Lord. Amen. Get outside of yourself. Get outside of the flesh and start walking in the Spirit of God. Amen. Amen.
just show what we're marching out to possess. And there's no way our minds will be turning. There's joy in the battle, so we commence to change this nation's course. The kingdom of God is suffering violence, and the violent turn can fight for.
God's got an army, not afraid to fight. Soldiers of the cross, children of the light. Warriors of righteousness, with healing in their hands.